the person who doesn't play Kirsten Razor or Dragon Ravine in their Pendulum Deck. Hey, you, sir, you're a first ballot Hall of Fame moron. And here's why.
8 turbo cards you're missing out on. Let me show you now the importance of my turbo stick to the game plan cards.
Enjoy me clopping the butt cheeks out of the next 4 duelists on Dueling But Graded.
This video is brought to you by me. So hit the subscribe button. Thanks. It don't matter if Electrum's at 1 or has been at 1 for a year now. You still have to play infinite turbo cards. This is not up for debate. This is why you guys suck with pendulums. Look at this hand. If Cerberus gets ashed, I pass my turn. If Cerberus gets ashed, go ahead, Bezashtian. Go ahead, Ash Blossom, my Cerberus. I'm passing my turn. It's all you after that. It's all you, bro. I pass my turn. Go ahead. Just go end me. End my misery. That's how people feel when they don't play Dragon Ravine or Curtain Razor. So he's not going to ash it. But you can't, look, if I play Cerberus, Ash, lose. Now I got Dragon Ravine or Curtain Razor or another card or another turbo card. Now what do you know? Now, what, you want to Ash my Ravine? No problem. No problem. First off, no one's Ashing a Ravine because they'll be scared of other stuff. But you're going to put the Cerberus, at the same time I discarded a Dark Room, so no one's Ashing a Ravine. Now you're safe through any hand trap. Would you like to Ash my Cerberus? Go straight ahead, brother. Go ahead, brother. Ash my Cerberus all you want. It's not going to do anything for you. We got 4 matches to do, so stay tuned to the very end. Hit the subscribe button right now. Stay tuned so I can show you guys all the reasons why Curtain Razor and Ravine and Terraforming are absolutely necessary. Especially stay tuned for the 4th match. The 4th match is going to blow your mind. Now, another reason why you play Ravine is for going second. It's not just about putting up negates. You got the turbo cards for first or second. Then you got the Desudo to whoop your opponent into oblivion going second. Now, we're going to go fast forward here. If he ashed the Cerberus, hey, we're good. We got the Dark Orb, Normal Harmonizing, got Electric, we're good. Hey, guess what? You got the most useless hand trap in the game, Phantasmate. Nice +1 that will do nothing to my +10. Like, bro, the only reason you play hand traps is to stop my turn. Not so you can go +1 on your turn and do... Hey, now you draw the Ash. Hey, he drew the Ash. If he had the Ash 1 card early, that's why I don't like Phantasmate, bro. That's why I don't even like hand traps. It was a 6 card. Phantasmate drew into the Ash. Guess what? Your Ash is useless anyways because now I got my big ass board. He's going to Ash after he with the Phantasmate. I'll have counters to negate it. But hey, if you had the Ash on the Cerberus, I was passing my turn. Hence, you need to play Dragon Ravine. You need to play Curtain Razor. It's not debatable. Now, I put the Phantasmate back in the Silent Vortex. It doesn't negate because I'll destroy a Vortex. And I end on a mediocre board here of 4 interruptions because it's going to bring up Persona Dragon, which is a new addition to my deck. Well, I was going to play Sky Iris Engine as well. Unfortunately, the Ash was clutch at the time, but still, you have 4 interruptions, which is more than what 99% of pendulum boards do anyways. I guess it's a basis. So, you already got your 4, and if this is a normal monster, if you had the cottage, the other Demeon was coming out as well, and you had the Pseudo, so you got to get another access to another monster, you could have had a Dragster as well. But hey, he's playing a free win Salamangreat, so we're good. We're just going to bounce a Falco back and win the duel. But hey, you called by the grave. I'm like, oh, not today, sir. Vortex that shit into oblivion. Hey, guess what, sir? Another call by the grave. Goodbye, Seal. He's going to get to resolve that, but that's totally okay because the deck still sucks. We're just going to Jackal anything that's important. We still have our Jackal save because call by the grave gave it counters. And we're just going to really wait here. Obviously, this is how you play properly. You want to be smart. You try to bait me into using Jackal because he had no play. I negated his Hito trying to get my Electrum because I don't care what the hell he adds to his hand. I'm OTKing him next turn. And of course, he's gonna pass because no monsters on board. The only way Salamangreat plays is if they have monsters. I don't want to give him an opportunity to have fires on board and go into more stuff. And if he played a high level Link mod, like the Link 4 or whatever, Link 3, Transcode, I don't know what the hell it's called, or whatever, not Transcode. The other one, it's like you just attack over my Jackal and I'll cry. And I just have Pen Summon and win. So, bring out the Strudo. Yeah, goodbye, sir. Goodbye. Nice to Strudo. You don't play the Strudo without Dragon Ravine, so yeah, play Dragon Ravine. Game 1 goes to me. I have 4 matches, but it's already 4 minutes long or 5 minutes long in the video, so maybe I'll do 2 or 3. Maybe I'll do more matches in the future video. Here we're going second. Obviously, we're going to 2-0 him probably because we 2-0 everyone we play as long as, you know, we draw good cards like Dragon Ravine and stuff. Now, look, if our Shrine gets Ash or something, now we got another way to Dark Worm. You need Dark Worm, bro. You need Dark Worm. If we got draw Curtain Razor, we're good. But you want to have 2 of the free summons if you don't control the monster. You want to see 2 of them. He tries to pop his scythe. Like, I knew it was a scythe because he used Rage to try and pop it. I don't even know. Can you even pop your own card? Then target 1 card in the field. Yeah, so he tried to pop his own scythe lock me while dwellering as a backup. But I was like, nah, son. I rebooted his ass. I didn't even mean to play reboot. I don't know why the hell. I think I sided one as a joke and I drew it. But hey, nice scythe. That shit's not coming out. And then he's gonna just have a dweller with a bunch of random stuff. Hey, dweller's the only situation where the Sturdo and shrine won't work, but that's totally okay because we play Carly, Pendulum, Carl. So we're good here. I'm gonna fast forward the rest because I'm gonna have two of them. Obviously, this is one dweller against my superior pendulums. Another reason why I'm gonna just hurry up here. I'm gonna bring up Cerberus instead. Cerberus is gonna banish this and whoop his ass. Now I'm gonna go fast forward for the rest of the duels so you can maybe get through as many as you can. I have like a bunch of duels ready that I'm testing all day today. I'm banning 85 days, baby. 85 days, baby! Almost there. I whooped his ass there. For some reason, I forgot he dwelled in my Yazi wasn't there, but hey, it doesn't matter. I whooped his ass anyways. Next one, we're playing Dinos. Dino, everything's a free win. So first we 2-0 Salamangreats. Now we're gonna play Dinos. Look at this hand, okay? Look at this hand. If he Ashes Mastery, I lose. I need another Dragon Intervener or Foolish. We're not always gonna draw Foolish or Shrine, right? The reason why I play 60 is not to draw your bricks or not draw doubles or like Spell Power Master or something like that. We end up drawing four of our seven in a 60 card deck of Endymion. So it's like, it really sucks in terms of ratios, but we got unlucky here. But hey, if we had a Curtain Raiser here, even if we got Ash, we were good. But again, he had no hand traps, so we're lucky. Except I think he had Phantasmite later. But we need a Curtain Raiser there. We need a Dragon Ravine there. If he hand trapped us once, it stopped the Mastery or stopped the Servant, I just lost. Again, like, I just did nothing and passed. Like, you need the Curtain Raiser or the Dragon Ravine. You just need them. And Dragon Ravine gives you Terraformings, which lets you sign the Blood Garden to clear Mystic Mind easier. Now we're going to keep going here. He's going to Phantasmite and negate it. I'm like, bro, what are you even doing? What's the point of doing that? And hey, like, in a weird, like, look at this. Like, bro, it's too good. Like, it's just too good, man. Like, we're going to Desires here. We're going to keep going. He allows you to play Set Rotation. You have so many ways. You get more Turbo Cards. Set Rotation now gives me 9 Turbo Cards you guys don't play. And if it was any other deck there, if they had tracked, I lost. Now 5 negates, he has 3 cards. I'm like, yeah, all right. Now he is playing, going second Dino. He's playing Lost World Dinos. Or I think something like, yeah, Lost Dino. What the hell? With that deck, you know. Now look at this hand. If I don't have Dragon Ravine here, what do I do? I lose! If I don't have Dragon Ravine, I have no Turbo Cards. Terraforming gets Dragon Ravine. Like, that's what got the... That's what's going to get the Countess for Servant. I played 30 Spell Cards in my deck. There's 36 Spell Cards. Yet Servant won't have Countess if I don't play Ravine. So this hand, I'm literally just passing to some Electrum after my Pen Summon garbage-ass 2 negate dead-ass, like, shit-ass board. And I'll get my ass whooped by... And then he had a Gamma, too. He had a Gamma and a Phantasmate, and I had, if I did not have this Dragon Ravine, I completely lost. I brought out Jacko before to save my Electrum, but he was going to negate the Jacko, Phantasmate is going to resolve, and I'm not going to be able to do a lot here, but hey, it's totally fine. I'm still going to, look, through the Gamma and the Phantasmate, I'm still going to end up with infinite, like, look at my board, I'm still going to have a big-ass board. Now, that is not possible without the Dragon Ravine. Without Dragon Ravine, I'm passing my turn. I'm like, go ahead, sir, with this Gamma would end me. Right now, look. I have five interruptions here. Well, 4 because this is gone. Oh, he's playing Madolche. Sorry, he's playing Madolche. This is Lost Dino is the other one. He's playing Going Second Madolche. Which Going Second Madolche with this card's really good. This card's actually really, really powerful. This card's really good. He played Going Second, like evenly matched Kaiju, stuff like that. But look, evenly matched. How many boards did he clear? He's playing Going Second deck with a bunch of one card combos. Evenly matched Slumber, Gamma, Phantasme, which I put back in his hand. Like, how many decks could clear that? Like, I still whooped his ass, couldn't do anything. And he had 2 starters. And he had 2 one-card combos, which is like a big-ass board. Next one. This one's a fantastic match. I want you guys to see this one. I'm going to go fast forward the whole way through, okay? So just stick with me and talk fast for this one. He's going first. I'm facing Orcust. This guy was a fantastic player. Shout out to this guy. He played it greatly, really good, really well. His first turn here, I really wanted him to not get the crescendo. I needed my Pendulum Call to resolve. My Pendulum Call, I'll be left with 5 cards versus 5 interruptions. But if it was the field spell, I'd be fine. Because you'll get Dragon Pit as soon as possible. You'll even, like, not even think about serving. You'll just get Dragon Pit as soon as possible. pop the field spell, and then his stuff's gonna be useless. Yeah, pop one muscle guards. I don't even care about that. But you don't want him to pop two. The twister hurt me there, and the pen call. I don't want my crescendo pen call getting crescendoed. The pseudo gave me a chance there, but he had four interruptions with twister popping two. Like, I couldn't do that. So now I go first. And hey, look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. I played 29 or 30 turbo cards. Curtain Razor saved my turn. Saved my hand. Again. Like, these are not duels I pick out randomly. These are, like, duels in a row. Hence, proving my point again. Curtain Razor saved my turn again. Like, without Curtain Razor or Dragon Ravine, I just straight up lost this turn. Like, obviously, any turbo card would have been nice. Chronograph, Cerberus, whatever it might be. But you just need to play infinite amount. I play, like, the max amount possible. I play 30. Like, I play 30 in a 60-card deck. Like, it was in a 50-card deck because 10 of them say draw. So, in a 50-card deck, I play 30 turbo cards. Yet, the only one I drew was a Curtain Razor. If I didn't play that Curtain Razor, I was ending on some garbage-ass board. Right? So, it's like, like, you need to play it. I can't emphasize this enough. Like, people don't play Curtain Razor Ravine because they think Ravine's a neg one, but it's not. Because you discard a card, but Dark Room, gate zero gets back the card you discard. And Curtain Razor is literally just free. And it, on top of that, gives a free counter to your Abductor and your Servant. Now, this hand could be good, but hey, we have double reboot in this hand. I sided two reboot. I only side six cards against Orcus, and it's only because I take out six cards I don't need going second. So I had six cards. I sided two reboot, two Twister, and Eccentric, and a Garuda. Because Eccentric and Garuda are searchable outs to their field spell or crescendo. So, it's definitely unfortunate that I drew double reboot because one's going to be useless, obviously. He saw my hand as well, so he's going to play around. He doesn't want crescendo now because he knows it. So now he's going to go for the field spell, and now he's going to cuck me a little bit. I got Redoer. Double Fog, which I'm going to stop, obviously, but it puts me at four cards I'm playing with. So I'm going to need to draw the Dragon Ravine or something like that, or Pen Call preferably, because I already have a Shrine. So now I don't need the Ravine. But, hey, we're going to keep going here. He redoers my Cerberus, which really, really hurt because my Cerberus wanted to get Garuda to pop the Babble. He's going to Fogblade the Dark Worm into baiting me to use a reboot, but I had to use a reboot in this situation regardless. And so I need to draw some good cards into the void. So you got two Upstart Goblins here. You're thinning out your deck to only the cards you need, hoping you don't draw bad cards. And, hey, so all we're left here is just that one interruption left. Just with the Skeleton Engrave into the void. Okay, wait, I see one good card, a double Shrine. If that was a Ravine, I think I won now. I had a great, would have had a good advantage or a chance at least. Because if it was a Terraforming, Ravine, then Servant would have had three counters. And I would have got into pseudo out here with the extra reboot. Would have had a Yazi, he'd have to be forced to pop it. Then Servant would come out, that will pop the remaining card. I'll build a Pendulum Summon, Guard Dragon combo, and win. Like, Electron, Pen, Dark Worm, and any monster is OTK. So, with Boros Sword and multiple monsters as well. It's pushing a long ass duel, but I'll show you one last duel. This one really shows the power of the deck. I'm going to fast forward the whole way through. I don't want this to be one long ass video, my last one. But look at this hand. Look at this hand. Look at this hand. One Ash I lose. Oh, look at that. Boom. Ash Blossom, I literally scoop. Look at the hand. Like, I'm going to replay it for you guys. Okay, I wanted to show you guys this one, okay? I played 30 turbo cards, okay? 30 with 30 spell cards to make sure Abductor resolves. Hey, guess what? You're gonna have hands where you don't draw them. I'm gonna redo this again. Okay, look. So I lose a die roll. He's playing, this one was going second dinos. So this guy was playing going second dinos. So we 2-0'd. We 2-0'd Salaman Great so far. We 2-0'd Madolche's with going second, like unbelievably amazing going second, but I destroyed him. We lost game 3 to Orcus. We got really unfortunate with drawing like double Shrine, double reboot, like stuff like that. And now, going second dinos, and the same thing I just showed you, the exact same hand I just showed you, I want to look at the hand. What's it missing? The Curtain Razor or the Ravine? The Curtain Razor or the Ravine? Like, I can't stress this enough, bro. I can't stress this enough. Like, you're an absolute moron if you don't play it. If I had a Curtain Razor or a Ravine, it doesn't help drawing Gate Zero, Jackal, or Time Gaze when you play only one of each and you only play one Mythical Beast in your main deck that's not Cerberus, but hey, we needed a Curtain Razor or Ravine. If we had one of them, we won. Next. This hand's better. Like, this hand's, like, actually too good. Like, I'm just going to fast forward the whole hand. I open Pen Call, Servant, Dark Room. Like, and I'm just going to keep going here. I'm going to do my turn fast. He's going to auto scoop. Now, I want you guys to keep in mind here one thing quick, okay? A lot of people are going to auto-scoop to your 5, 6, 7, 8 negates. A lot of people are going to auto-scoop to it. So you need generic cards to go second. So when you side, make sure you side a Garuda and a Eccentric going second always. because you don't know what he's playing. They're gonna scoop to 5-6 negates auto scoop if they don't know. So they don't. So you won't know what they're playing. But what I like to do aside those two and triple Dino Wrestler. So three Dino Wrestler, one Eccentric, and one Garuda. Eccentric searchable with Abductor, Garuda searchable with Cerberus, and three Wrestler. You got five great side deck cards, and two of them are searchable by half your deck in case you play Mystic Mind. Now we're going, he's playing going second, so he made me go first. He made me go first, or I think he passed his turn. He went for, he's playing going second Dinos. He should have made me go first. But he decided to go first and he passed his turn. Obviously he has a shit ton of hand traps. So he asked Boston that, you know what I should have done? I should have just put Gate Zero and Chronograph and Scale, Pendulum Summon everything. Would have been the same result. So this is unfortunate on my end. Like it's Gamma, Ash and Gamma, that's fine. It's part of the game. It's totally cool. Now he's going to, I think this is game two, I believe. No, it's game three, sorry. The first one was done in 2 seconds. Things are looking big here. Looks like I'm going to lose, but hey, you never give up, right? You never give up. He's playing going second Dinos. He bricked a little as well, but that's what happens when you play infinite hand traps, right? Now, look at this. Hi, Curtain Razor. I'm not gonna need you here, though, but look at this. This is why you also have to play Dragon Ravine. If you do not play Dragon Ravine, you don't play Mirror in your deck, right? Because you're not going to play Destrudo. You need to play both. Now, look at this. Now, since you're forced to play Dragon Ravine, you go second. Now, you get to have access to Yazzie. Without Yazzie, I lost this duel. My Electrum's gone. I'm up with three monsters on board. I won't accomplish anything. I'm at 600. He has Lost World in his hand. Look at his hand. Dino, like, I don't do shit. I just passed my turn. I know he has shit like Dino Wrestler. I know he has shit like Lost World. I know all that stuff. So he couldn't do anything in this situation. He had no Dino, unfortunately, but whatever. But I knew that. So look, without Dristrudo, Mare, I lost. And then I saw, now look at this, Dragon Caller, another card no one plays. Dragon Caller, make the token a dragon. Now I'm going to guard Dragon Combo, bring a Boral Sword. Like, all because Dragon Caller targeted my token, but none is possible without Destrudo. This deck absolutely needs Dragon Ravine, Terraforming, Curtain Razor. I will not take no for an answer, it's on non-negotiable. And enhance, you need to play Destrudo and Mirror and cut down all the stupid bricks, like bad shit magicians, 2 level 7 magicians, 2 low skill magicians, 2 high skill magicians, 2 harmonizings, and a Dragon Caller fits all those categories. So it's just the best one. You don't need Pearl Poison, Black Fang, they'll suck. That's the video, guys. I hope my infinite knowledge was bestowed upon you guys today. I hope you guys learned something. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hit that subscribe button and throw Curtain Razor, Dragon Ravine in your deck. We'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. Peace.